I am Karen Pinto.
Hi, my name is Deepanya.
I'm Tanya Desai.
My name is Raihan Navroz.
Yes, I hosted an international intern.
I took this step last year, last summer.
Her name was Vilawan Daduan.
She was from Turkey.
My parents are the kind of people that are not very open to the idea of someone coming and living in their home. Especially not like a complete stranger from another country.
It was something which was difficult for me in the beginning, but my parents, they gave me a chance of hosting someone for first, like for 2 days or something. I had an intern who came down for 2 days, and after that, my parents, they bonded with the intern more than I did.
My mom and dad made an attempt to talk to her, and she responded very well. And I remember there was this day, like around 4 weeks after she came to my house. When I came back home, I saw my dad and her discussing politics in China and talking about how the media is very restrictive there, and my dad would ask her like 1,000 silly questions as to, okay, is it really true that this happens in China? Do you all eat dogs in China? And she would very sincerely sit and answer all of his questions, and they would discuss all of that. She would do that with my mom also. She would tell my mom about the cuisine in China, and she would actually teach my mom, you know, okay, so this is how we do this in China. And yeah, like, I had never imagined seeing my parents being so open.
Kimball is around the same age as I am. He is actually of Chinese origin, but he stayed in Canada his entire life. And he's a student from University of Toronto. And he's like a completely different person than who I am. Like, he studies science, whereas I'm an art student. So we never like had that common ground apart from that. But it's really great because I used to live in the US for a long time, so I really understood where he was coming from in terms of like adapting to India. And the great part about him is that he actually volunteered in Kenya before. So he was really open to, you know, like adapting to India and things like that.
Like, we went over VTs, Futowa Bridge, and looked down, and you could actually see the train coming into CST, and like 1,000 people getting out of it, and then the next 1,000 people getting into the train. She was really fascinated.
At the end of the experience, my mom had wanted to leave.
My parents definitely considered her as their own daughter. They would always like tell people, we have two daughters now. One is an Indian, one is Chinese.
My mom used to ask me every day, like, when she going, and then at the end, she's like, oh shit, she's leaving today, oh shit, that's too quick.
The experience was the least bit unique for me. It was way more unique for my sister, for my mom, for my maid, and it opened their mind.
In today's day and age, it's very important for us as young people to know what's going on in the world, and often, we all know that often media does not give us a true reflection of that. So the best way of doing that to know the world is to either travel, or the second best option is to get people to come and stay in your house from different parts of the world.
Reason my experience was way different from anyone else's experience was because it was my own experience. Like, you can hear 1,000 second-hand stories, you can hear 1,000 first-hand stories, but when you have your own experience, that's when that you're having that experience is so much better than just hearing stories. That's when you actually realize that these stories had so much more emotion and thought behind them.
My home is a global home.
I have a global home.
I have a global home.
I have a global home.
Do you?